by now. It's all about having fun with art. Well, this video is all about making things the art attack way. Now, I'm sure you have loads of ideas of your own, but there are plenty of ideas that you can try out straight away on this video. Now, on art attack itself, I try not to use any fancy art materials. Instead, I use a load of old rubbish. Literally. I don't throw anything away. I keep leftover bits and pieces in my special art store. And here it is. Look at this lot. Now, there are hundreds of potential art attacks in here. With this lot and some ordinary PVA glue, you can create almost anything. Now, you will have seen me using this stuff a lot. Loo rolls, kitchen rolls, and various tissue papers. I use them all the time with PVA glue to give models and things lots of strength. By adding layers of loo roll or kitchen roll or basic tissue paper to your model and gluing it into place with PVA glue, you can make even the most delicate model strong and solid. And tissue paper and glue are the starting point for this wonderful art attack, a fantasy island. Yep, you can design your very own island. It's so easy to do. To make your dream island, take a piece of cardboard box card and start by drawing a rough design of the shape of your island. And make sure you leave loads of space around the edge for the sea. Now I'm doing an island with a cove here, a beach, two hills. Now to create the 3D shape of your island, scrunch up some balls of tissue paper or loo roll and dip them into some PVA glue mixed in equal parts with water. And just dip the bottom of those balls in and then put them onto your drawn island. Now to create hills for your island, just scrunch up bigger balls of tissue paper or loo roll, and again dip those into the PVA and water mixture, just the bottom of the ball and the glue. You can actually use newspaper for this if you want, and just press that onto the island. And then the messy bit. It wouldn't be art attack if there wasn't a messy bit. Yeah, look at that lot. Just slot the PVA glue all over those tissue balls, and then take some more strips of tissue paper or loo roll, place those over those soggy tissue balls, and then just with your fingers roughly press the tissue into the shape, a little squidgy inside there, and then make it even messier. Look at this. There's some people all over the land now going, oh, that looks terrible. Oh, look, brilliant in here. More glue on the top, and then just take the paintbrush and very carefully just smooth all of that tissue into the shape of your island. And make sure you smooth some flat bits around the outside edge for the beach. Now, if you want to put some trees on your island, just screw up or scrunch up some tiny balls of tissue paper or loo roll, and place those in the glue like that, put them into position, and dab the PVA glue on the top. When the glue dries, it'll go really hard, and those trees will look brilliant. Now, if you want to create some buildings, just cut little square scraps of cardboard, that's just tiny bits of cardboard, dab some glue, I've got loads of glue there, so I just put one on top of the other, like that, and then for the roof of the building, just fold over a small square of paper, see that, just created it into a roof, place that on the top, and position it wherever you want on the island. And the idea is to just build the island up, just use your imagination. In fact, it's great fun trying to work out where you're going to put everything, and don't forget, it's your dream island, so you can do what you want. When the whole thing is dry, look at this, it's gone rock solid, and these really do look like cliffs, and you've got all the buildings and these solid trees up there. And now to turn it into a paradise island, and you do this by painting it. And what I've done with this one here is I've painted the cliffs a nice grey, or you could even use brown. The idea is to just really press your paint into all those nooks and crannies. A critical poster for this, doesn't matter which paint you use. Now, for the tops of the cliffs and the trees, give it a really nice paradise feel and use some bright green. Just want to slip that on the top, like that. And for the trees, you could always mix in some darker greens just to pick those trees out. You could even put some yellows on there just to pick out some highlights, make it lots of nice greenery. Caribbean blue. We could even mix in some other blues, streak some other blues in there to give it a good water effect. Now, see this shimmering surf effect? I have to admit, I'm a cheat. To get that, I use some of this stuff, just ordinary kitchen cling film. And it's just a case of when your paint is dry, slot some glue on just to the C area, and then just cut bits of this cling film, place them into the glue, and then wrinkle them up to create the waves. And if you do lots of waves by the cliffs, they look like crashing waves. And when you finish the whole C, it looks something like that. And look at that, I've painted the beach a nice sandy yellow, I've painted the buildings a wooden brown, and that's it. Your own dream island. And if you do a few of them, you could create a group of dream islands. They look brilliant, don't they? Well, what about creating a nightmare island? Try it yourself, your own dream island. Now, for many of the things that I make on Art Attack, I use stuff like newspaper and cardboard box card, which you can probably find at any time. But there are some special things around your home, which are definitely worth keeping your eye on, because you want to make sure that they don't get thrown out when they're finished with. Washing up liquid bottles are a really good example. Now, I know you don't get empty ones that often, but you want to make sure that they don't just get chucked away automatically when they're finished with, because they are brilliant for some art attacks. Like this one, an Art Attack paint tube for keeping all your art materials in. Take a look at this. Take an empty washing up liquid bottle, take the squeezy top off and thoroughly wash it out. And when it's dry, cut the bottom of the bottle. Now these plastic bottles can be quite difficult to cut. You know my motto, it's difficult. Get someone else to do it. Then cut the top 2 centimetres from this sloping neck. And the idea is to keep 2 centimetres of the body on. Cut all the way round, apart from about 2 centimetres. So you've got a waggling hinge. Then squeeze the bottom of the bottle to get the shape of your paint tube. And securely tape it to that position. Now you can take a lot of time doing that. I don't get that much time on Art Attack, so I'm just doing it quickly to show you. Then take a sheet of newspaper, close the newspaper, and place a ruler at the bottom, and then just roll the ruler inside the newspaper, like that, and then take the ruler out and wrap that rolled piece of newspaper around the bottom of your tube, overlap it there, and where it overlaps, again, tape it thoroughly and securely into place. Another one on there to show you. Again, you put loads of tape on. Now, to make the top of your paint tube, take the lid off a plastic drinks bottle or a plastic milk bottle. I'm going to take this one here, place that on the top there like that, and that will be the lid of your paint tube. And again, just tape that into place. Make it as neat as you can. On there, like that. Put the tape around the edges. And then to neaten the whole thing up and make it nice and secure, mix some PVA glue with a little bit of water. Now, you've seen this PVA glue before. It's the old school glue you get in the white squidgy bottles. In fact, I use this so often, people are starting to call this Art Attack glue. So just paste some of that onto that top there. And you know what I'm going to do. You've seen me do this before. A bit of papier-mâché. Put little bits of newspaper on there. And the idea is to just press the newspaper down to all those nooks and crannies. Again, you can take your time doing that. And do exactly the same with the tube itself. To neaten it up, slop on your glue and stick on bigger strips of newspaper to cover all those gaps and all those joins. And it's very important that you put some bigger strips on and overlap them down inside your tube. I'll just turn that around there to show you. Overlap them about 2 centimetres inside the tube. You don't want to go all the way down, just about 2 centimetres. And do that all around the tube. Cover the tube the same way. And when it's done, you'll have into shape, and then get your fingers in there and spring it out into shape so that it's a perfect fit. And you could always just close it just to test that it's a good fit, but make sure you open it to dry it out. And when it's dry, you could paint it. Now, you could do any paint tube design you like. You could copy a real paint tube, or you could make your own one, but I find it's a good idea to paint it white to start with on the paint tube itself. I'm just slipping that on there to show you. And then you could always paint the metal bits a sort of grey with grey silver. And when you've done the whole thing again, you take your time doing it. Poster paint or acrylic paint. And when it's done, it looks something like that. So see what I've done here? I've painted it white, I've painted the metal bits a grey silver, I've painted the lid black, and I've even put on a strip of red here to show what colour paint is inside my paint tube. And to design the label itself, I've copied a real paint tube, I've written on red. You can write on Art Attack, or you can write on your own name, because after all, it is your paint tube. And all these other little bits and pieces and details, I've just copied on a real paint tube. And then you just open it up, and you pop in paintbrushes, and pens, and other art materials. In it goes, all your art stuff, and just close the lid, and there it is, your own Art Attack paint tube. Try it yourself. Excuse me. Now, yeah, I know what you're thinking. What's he doing taking time off from making this video to have a break and eat a nice lolly? Well, that's where you're wrong. Because what I'm doing is I'm creating art materials. Can't you tell? And now you're probably thinking, what's he talking about? Well, apart from being great to eat, by finishing off this lolly, I've been left with a great art material. A lolly stick. Instead of just chucking it in the bin, keep it, wash it, and use it. And since this video is all about making things, here's a great idea that involves making something out of lolly sticks. Take a look at this easel. It's made entirely out of lolly sticks, and it's a perfect way to turn a picture into a masterpiece. To make a photo easel, you'll need some of these things, lolly sticks. Now, you can buy these in packets from supermarkets or even art and craft shops, or you could collect your own when you've finished eating your lollies. But get sucking, because you'll need 8 of these all together. Now, take 2 lolly sticks, and then take some PVA glue or some good, strong, all-purpose glue, and squeeze a blob onto the end of one of the sticks, like that, and just overlap the other stick by about 2 centimetres and press it down into the glue like that. And just press it firmly into place and hold it till it's dry. And when it's dry, you'll have one long stick that looks like that. Then make another long stick in the same way, using 2 lolly sticks, and then place them side by side on a flat surface and just press them together. Just push them together like that so that they nearly touch at the top, but not quite. So you've got sort of an A shape. Then take your photograph that you want to frame, place it in the middle of the sticks like that, and push it slightly up to the top there. So it's slightly nearer the top than the bottom. And then let it fall onto the sticks gently. Try not to let the sticks move. And then take your glue and put a blob of glue above the photograph onto each stick. Try not to get any glue in your photo. And then a blob of glue on each of the sticks below the photo. Again, try not to make anything move here. You notice you've got nice clean sticks here. That's because we wash them after we eat the lolly. Try not to make anything move there. And then take another stick, place it in the glue below your photo, first time we did it, but now it's half a stick. See that? And glue those two together like that, so you then have something that looks like that. And that will now be your stand. Then take that half stick that we put to one side. And the idea is to draw around that onto a piece of good, strong drawing paper and cut it out so that you have a similar shape to that, only in paper, so it's like a paper flap. Throw this half stick away. Now you won't need that, but you will need this paper flap. And the idea is to fold that in half. That can be a bit fiddly, so do it carefully. Just fold it in half, like that. And then open it out again and take some more glue and just smear some glue all over the inside of that paper flap. And then very carefully, just place the tip of your stand over the edge of that paper flap into the glue, and then close the flap like that so that it sandwiches the stand, and half of the paper is gripping the stand there, and the other half of the paper is sticking to itself, and just hold that into position till it's dry. When it is dry, you'll have a strong paper flap on the end of your stand sticks. And then you just stick that to the back of your photo easel frame on that top crossbar up there, and you just put a dab of glue in the back of that top crossbar and place that flap into the glue and hold it firmly in place till it's dry. And again, when that's dry, you now have this strong paper hinge at the top that forms your stand. And then it's ready to paint. And you paint it using a nice light brown poster or acrylic paint, and just slop it onto your easel, all over the easel, paint the whole thing, front and back. I'll just do this bit quickly to show you. And when your paint is dry, you can add on some felt-tip pen detail. And that's exactly what I did with this one. Let's have a look at this. What I've done is the old wispy black lines with a thin black felt-tip pen there to create the wood grain effect. That's very easy to do. And I used a silver pen to put dots here to look like nails on the joints. And then to stop it falling over, I've just tied some thin string around the legs and around the back of the stand, so it doesn't open out too far. And then it's simply a case of positioning your stand wherever you want to, and place your photograph on your photo easel stand. Look at that, a real masterpiece. Try it yourself, a photo easel. Now, as I said earlier, most of the stuff that I use for my art attacks is just rubbish that you're gonna throw away. But this next art attack does need something that you have to go out and buy from art shops or even chemists. This stuff, plaster of Paris. Now, if you haven't used it before, you just mix it with water, pour it into a mould of some sort, and it goes rock solid. But just take a look at this star sign wall plaque. It looks good, doesn't it? Well, this was made with just plaster of Paris and a little bit of help from a margarine tub. Now, you need an empty, clean margarine tub. The bigger you can find, the better. And I've got one with a round bottom there. And then take a clump of plasticine big enough to fit into the palm of your hand and roll it into a ball. And then squash it on a flat surface into a flat, circular pancake. You need to just press down on top of it, like that, so that it's about 1 centimetre thick. So that it's big enough to just fit into the bottom of your margarine tub, like that. And it has to leave a gap of at least 1 centimetre around the edge. That's very important. You'll see why in a minute. Then take the flat surface of your plasticine and draw any design you like into it. I'll tell you what looks really good. Your star sign. Now, of course, your star sign depends on what birthday you are. If you don't know what your star sign is, or even what it looks like, why don't you look in the daily newspapers? They always have little drawings of them in there on the stars page. Now, my birthday is in October, so I'm Libra, which is Scalers. So I'm just going to draw in the blue pencil set of Scalers. Now, I have to draw a complicated picture. It's a very simple picture, and very effective. And don't press in too hard. You don't want to go right through the plasticine. tail of the thing, and the stars starts out a little bit messy below. You watch what happens. The stars around there. And then just place the plasticine in the bottom of your margarine tub. Now again, this is very important. You have to press the edges down with your finger so that they're very firm onto the margarine tub. This is so when you put the plaster of Paris mixture in, you don't want it to seep underneath. And if you do squash any of your picture at this stage, you just go over it again in pencil. And you've done that now, that's nice and solid. Then take 5 tablespoons of plaster of Paris powder, even a plaster of Paris in the chemist or the art shop, and mix it with about a mugful of water. When you go and get a plaster of Paris, you can always use some moulding powder in the art shops. And if you get a packet of this, all the packet will do, loads of these, so it's good value. And then just pour your plaster of Paris mixture into the margarine tub, like that. There it goes, and then cut a length of string that's about 40 centimetres long, lay it over your tub like that, and then press the middle of the string down so that it goes into the plaster of Paris about 1 centimetre. Just hold it in there, like that, and then leave it to set. And look, do me a favour, if you've got any plaster of Paris mixture left over, don't pour it down the drains, because when it's set, it'll block them up. Just pour it into a plastic bag, and when it sets, put it in the bin. Now, it'll take about half an hour for your plaster of Paris to set, and when it's set, it's got rock solid like this, and the string is firmly stuck in there. And then just crack the outside of your margarine tub, and press out. Look at that, you've got a 3D plaster of Paris, it's like a sculpture at the moment, isn't it? Now, the idea is to paint it, and you can use acrylic paint or poster paint, but it's best to just slosh on a layer of paint first to seal in the plaster of Paris. And I'm just going to slosh on this blue to show you. Actually, blue works very well because of the star sign and the midnight blue. And just slop it on, even very neat about it. I'm just sloshing it on there to show you. And when it's covered, you'll have something that looks like that. And now the good bit. Pick out the detail. Using a gold or a silver pen. Lovely, so I'm just going down all the raised bits, all these 3D bits. With this great effect here. If you go around the outside, on there, it creates a frame. And again, around there, you can do the whole lot, do it very neatly. It takes a bit of time to do. When it's finished, you'll have something that looks like that. Look at that. And what I've done is I've even tied the string on the back so I can hang it up, snipped off the excess bits, and that's it. That is my star sign, Libra. And there are 12 star signs to choose from. Find out which is yours. Now, it could be one of these. It could be Cancer, the crab. Or it could even be Pisces, the fish. But if you can't find your star sign, why not design your own? Look at that, that star sign, the sun and the moon. So try it yourself, a 3D plaster of Paris picture. One of the things I make sure never gets thrown out are these things. Cardboard tubes, whatever shape or size they are. And you know, the best of all these tubes are loo roll tubes. Now, in most people's houses, they're disappointed when they run out of loo roll. But in my house, whenever we run out of loo roll, I'm absolutely delighted, because it means there's another tube for me to get my hands on. Well, here's a really neat art attack that you can build up each time there's a new loo roll tube available in your house. Build your own totem pole. Brilliant art attack, totem poles. Now, tribesmen carved their totem poles out of hollowed out tree trunks. Now, we're going to carve our totem poles out of hollowed out loo roll tubes. Now, you can use as many as you want, and the idea is to stack them one on top of each other. And to get them to join together, we'll have to make some cardboard collars. And to do this, cut some strips of cereal box card, and you need to have strips that measure the same width as your loo roll tube, but a couple of centimetres taller. You need 3 of those, and then just roll it up like that, and pop it into the top of your loo roll tube, and just force it out to the shape of your loo roll tube, and press it in so it goes about halfway in, and then glue or tape it securely in place. And when your tape or your glue is dry, do the same with the rest of your loo roll tubes, and you have some really secure bizarre as you possibly can. Because you see, those tribesmen in Western America from Canada, they used to make some really weird and bizarre carvings, and they were based on their chief's family, the history of their chief. And it was so weird, maybe it was to frighten other tribes away or something like that. But I think it's great fun to make some really gruesome faces. Model them on whoever you like, really. Maybe even your own family. And when you've got it to this stage, you can, if you want, paint it. But if you want to make it look realistic, make it look really carved, then add some 3D to the features. And you can pop on some cut-out bits of cardboard. There's a nice cardboard nose. Or what about this? Why not mix some PVA glue in equal parts with water, and then dip in some scrunched up bits of blue roll or tissue paper, just dipping them in there, scrunch those up. And it's just a case of pressing them onto your blue roll tube and moulding them into place to give a nice carved 3D feel. And if you do the whole of your blue roll tube in exactly the same way, when the glue is dry, look at that, the tissue paper has gone rock solid and it really does look carved. And again, do all the blue roll tubes in exactly the same way, only design each one a bit different from the others, and you have something that looks like that. Then decide which one you want to go on the bottom. I think I'll use that one on the bottom, and cut a good stiff card square from cereal box card, and the sides of that square need to measure roughly the same as the height of your blue roll tube, and then just put a load of glue on the bottom of this blue roll tube. And just stick it securely to that cardboard base. I'm just going to leave it to one side to dry. And when it's drying, you can take one of your other blue roll tubes and paint it up. Because you've done such gaudy faces, it's a good idea to use gaudy colours. You just paint his tongue to show you. And if you do them all in the same way, you can add on more bits of detail with felt tip pen. And when finished, they look something like that when your paint's dried, and it's just a case of stacking them one on top of the other with your cardboard collars, and there it is, or with a bit of sticky out card and tissue paper, your own homemade totem pole. Now you can of course do one based on bizarre and weird faces like this one I've done here, or you can try a themed totem pole. What about doing the theme of the family? And on the bottom is long-suffering dad, and then on top of him is mum, and then on top of mum is screaming baby. Or what about doing an animal theme? What about a cheeky monkey on the bottom, and a fierce tiger with cardboard bristles there, and an owl at the top with cardboard wings? Or what about, you could even try a sporty one, and on the bottom there I've got a rugby player, and then a tennis player with cardboard arms and racket, a cricket player, and on the top, a hockey player. Try it yourself, your own homemade totem pole. You know, there are lots of art materials that can be used on their own. But some of my favourite art attacks are when you make something using lots of different bits and pieces. Such as this, a fantasy flyer. Great, isn't it? But can you see that it's made out of a pile of rubbish that was cluttering the drawer? I just kept adding and adding to it as I cleared out the drawer. So if you've got a cupboard or a drawer that needs clearing out, the chances are you'll have enough stuff to make your own fantasy flyer. However, you will have to find one particular thing to start you off. Now the secret weapon is these things, wedge-shaped boxes that have got one end narrower than the other. And you can get lots of boxes like this. You can get chocolate boxes, sweet boxes, and you can get loads of these chip boxes anywhere. So take one of these wedge-shaped boxes and place it onto a good strong piece of cardboard box card, and then just draw a wing on either side. Now, do nice, chunky, triangular wings. Don't do flimsy long ones. They don't need to be too long. The idea is to make strengthens the wing if you tuck it into the side there. And then you could also take some of these cardboard Luro tubes, split them down the middle like that, and just place them all over the body of your player, and they make it look really modern and high-tech, because these do look like extra fuel tanks and extra jets. The more the merrier. I think I'll put another jet down the top there, and then you could turn it over and put some little fuel tanks or jets on the wing. And see what I'm using here? Old 4-point pens. You know me, I don't ever throw anything away. I've got another one on the other wing like that. And the more bits of rubbish that you put on, the better. It's just a case of testing things to see if they look good. That looks good. Another bottle top there. And I've cut this bit from an old egg box. And I'll just put that on there, and that can be the cockpit of my plane. And around the back here, I've cut another little wing, and I'm just going to stick that under the jets for the back bit. Now you can see what I've done here. I've stuck this all together using little bits of tape, but you should use lots of tape or good strong glue and do it as neat as you can. And when you've got it to this stage, you can paint it. Now you can paint it using acrylic paint or poster paint. If you're going to use poster paint, it's a good idea to mix in a little bit of PVA glue, so then your paint will stick to all these plasticky bits on your plane. And of course, you're the designer, so you paint it any colour you want. I'm doing white here as a base colour, but you can do it camouflage, RAF colours, space colours, whatever you want. And then you can add on detail. And when it's finished, it'll look brilliant. And here's mine. See that? I think that looks absolutely fantastic. Look at that. And I've drawn on other little bits of detail with felt-tip pen, and I've stuck on more little bits of rubbish, and it looks brilliant. Look at that. There's a felt-tip pen lid. I was going to throw that away, but I've kept that. And how's about some plastic drinking straws? There's tubes and jets, and I've coloured that with a silver pen. I've done the same on the cockpit, silver pen. Other bits of detail with black pen, painted on some signs, painted on my initials, and look at the back. More drinking straws, and I've painted those with silver pen. And you know, I think that looks as if it's come straight out of the latest science fiction movie. And of course, you're the designer, so you can paint it any colour you like. What about this? Bright pink with silver glitter stars. It's a sort of spice jet. What about this one? This is more of a demon fighter. Look at that. It's black. I've painted on some fire, and it looks as if it's roaring through the skies. Try it yourself. Design your own futuristic fantasy flyer. Well, that's just about it for this video. Hope you've enjoyed it and it's made you think, yeah, I want to have a go at that. Well, now's the time, because you can. You can heart attack. Go on, try it yourself. Now, at the beginning, I said that this was the third in a set of three try-it-yourself heart attack videos. The first one is about drawing, and the second one